Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. And well, we just finished up the spring seminar season, and I love doing the seminars because lots of times someone in the audience will show me a brand new trick, and I have one of those today. I was out near Philadelphia, and Rich raised his hand and said, okay, well, you have that pivot table now, but I need to filter. I need to see all the records where the profit is greater than 50,000. And well, we can't do that in Excel 2003. In fact, if you would go to Data, Filter, and try AutoFilter, it's grayed out. Well, also in that seminar was Dan. Dan raised his hand and he said, well, wait a second, I found a great workaround for this. He says, what you do is you come here to the cell right next to the heading rows. So in this case, that would be cell G4. Start in that cell, hold down the shift key and use the arrow keys to select all the headings. Now, because we started outside of the pivot table, when you go to Data, Filter, AutoFilter is available. This is amazing. Turn on the AutoFilter and now I can create any kind of filter I want. So, for example, if I come to the profit heading, I would ask for a custom and say I want to see where it is greater than 50,000. Click OK, and amazingly, I've filtered the results of the pivot table. Let's go back, Data, Filter, Show All. You know, there is a way to show the top 10 customers or top 5 customers. Double click on Customer, click on Advanced, and then turn on the top 10 auto show and ask for the top 5. Click OK. But the problem with that is it shows us the top 5 customers and then the total for only those 5. I always like to see the total for everyone. So what we can do instead is kind of look at this and say, all right, basically everyone larger than 600,000 is in the top 5. So we'll clear that top 10 auto show, turn that off, and instead come here to the revenue drop down, create a custom filter, and say I want to see where the revenue is greater than 600,000. Click OK, and there is our top 5 with a grand total of everybody, because of course the grand total is greater than the 600,000. An amazing trick. I want to send a thanks out to Dan and Philly for showing us how we can create filters within a pivot table. The trick again is just to start right out here, right outside of the pivot table. Now, by the way, when you want to turn this off, normally if you're inside the pivot table, you can't go and uncheck auto filter, but you have to come to that extra cell and use Data, Filter, Auto Filter to turn the auto filter off. Very, very cool trick. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.